geographical features of Telangana. Location and geographical conditions have imparted a kind of significance to the new state formed in the integral part of Indian Peninsula, which was called Dakshinapatha in ancient period and the Deccan in the medieval and the later periods. Geographically, it is situated between the 15°55' to 19°55' north latitudes and 77°22' 0.35 to 81°2.23' east longitude, sir. And that is it is situated between 15 degrees 55 to 19 degrees 55 north latitudes and 77°22' 0.35 77°22' 0.35 to 81°2.23' east longitudes. It is in reality the location and geographical conditions of Telangana can be described as a unique. Why? Because even though the region was staggered along with the Andhra right from the prehistoric period to the formation of the separate Telangana to the formation of separate Telangana state in 2014. Telangana has its iron distinct geographical, political, economic, social and cultural history. The rivers and mountains in Telangana helped it to acquire a speciality. For instance, while there are Godavari and Pranahita rivers in the north, the Krishna and Tungabhadra rivers are on the south of the state. Different mountain ranges have given a distinct geographical appearances. Geographical features extending from the Dhindi river in the Nalgonda district to Kandikal in Khammam. That is, different mountain ranges have given a distinct geographical appearances and geographical features extending from Dhindi river in the Nalgonda district to Kandikal in Khammam district. Dhindi river in Nalgonda district to Kandikal in Khammam district appears as a natural boundaries that separate Telangana from Maharashtra in the north and Karnataka in the west. If the other hills and the mountains are taken into consideration, the Nallamala hills, which form the part of the eastern Ghats, started from the Srikakulam in Andhra Pradesh, are also present in Mehbub Nagar district in Telangana. After their separation from the Ajanta caves, Sahyadri mountain ranges of the western Ghats entered Telangana from the south and southwest, enters Telangana from the southwest and enter the state in Adilabad district. They are known as different local areas by distinct different names, such as Nirmal Guttalu, Rakhi Guttalu, Karimnagar, and Kandikal Guttalu, Khammam and Warangal. We have also see Khammam district, Kandikal river, Dhindi river, Nalgonda. So if you come to the rivers, Telangana is a hub of many rivers. Out of a total 720 kilometers of running stream of Godavari, both Andhra Pradesh, 720 kilometers of Godavari, both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana combined, which has a strong cultural links with the Telugu people, 79% is there in Telangana only. Similarly, in respect of 450 kilometers, both states put together, Krishna river, which enters the Telangana near Siddheshwaram, out of its total, that is a sea. Similarly, in respect to 450 kilometers of both the states put together, Krishna river, which enters Telangana near Siddheshwaram, out of its total flow, 68.5% is in Telangana. In this way, both Godavari and Krishna river, help immensely to make the new state rich in agricultural crops. There are also many tributaries, among them Tungabhadra, Bhima, Manjira, Pranahita, Musi, Dindi, Paler, Munner, Penganga, Varada are important. In the view of uneven and hilly terrain, Telangana is ideally situated for tanks. Realizing this scientific aspect, the Kakatiya period took up construction of tanks such as Ramappa, Pakala, Laknavaram, and Ghanpur in Warangal district, and remained famous for those days till today. At the time of the Andhra Pradesh formation, the integration of Telangana unit, there were about 20,000 tanks, big and small, put together. If you look at the climate of Telangana is hot and humid from March to September, and the temperature during the remaining months. The year is divided into four seasons. The winter extends from December to February, and summer generally prevails from March to May. Southwest monsoon gives rains from the June to September. October and November are characterized by the end of the re-coming of monsoon. Another important point is that hilly regions and those areas that are close to the Godavari and Pranahita rivers, are affected with a healthy malaria atmosphere as against the central plain areas enjoying the healthy atmosphere. See, that is, those areas close to the Godavari and Pranahita are affected on the malaria atmosphere against the central plain areas enjoying healthy atmosphere on untouched by malaria. And with the advent of the northwest monsoon, there will be a sudden increase in the humidity in the month of June. Humidity in the air remains from 65% to 80% as dry atmosphere prevails during the winter. This gradually comes down as summer enters from March to May. Humidity in the air comes down to 25%. But it needs to be noted that the amount of dry weather would be lower in Telangana than Marathwada during the summer. This is because extensive forest areas in Telangana, on the amount of which the humidity in the air continues to be some extent, either tanks or forest, are not very much there in Marathwada. During the monsoon and the post-monsoon periods, cyclones and low pressure cantels are formed in the Bay of Bengal. As they move west and the northwest, weather in Telangana gets affected. As a result, widespread heavy rains and strong winds occur. Thunder showers essentially occur in the summer, and southwest monsoons are there. Dusty winds blow generally in the summer and during the afternoon times. If you look at the temperature starts rising from the end of February and reaches its peak in May. On some days in the month, temperature in places like Hanumakonda, Khammam, Bhadrachalam and Ramagundam would touch the 47 degrees centigrade. However, as thunder showers occur on some days in the afternoons, people use it to get the relief from the hot winds. The temperature will decrease from the second week of the June with the entry of the northwest monsoon. By the first week of October, June monsoon gets over, the day temperature slightly gets reduced. After the October day, the temperature rapidly and cold weather would be higher in December, with high temperatures began coming to as low degrees centigrade. As February temperature begin rising during July, August, September months, westerly winds, and in October, November, December, January and February easterly winds, and in March, April, May northwesterly winds blow frequently. In the second half of the summer, during the early period of the southwest monsoon, lighter to moderate heavy winds occur. Mineral resources importance impact. Economically, Telangana has natural resources and wealth plenty. There is no paucity of minerals. Tandoor, Adilabad, Singareni, Kothagudam, Khammam have abundant coal deposits. They come from abundant coal deposits as a part of huge supply to the railways. They also provide iron ore mines in Khammam, Adilabad and Warangal regions. Asbestos, limestone, slabstone are also available in plenty. Against this background, Khammam, Mahabubnagar, Adilabad, Rangareddy and Nalgonda districts are having varied mineral resources. Based on all these, cement industry got centered in Nalgonda district. Khammam, Mahabubnagar, Adilabad, Rangareddy, these are mineral resource districts. Granite stones are extensively available in Telangana in different colors. They are being used widely in the construction of buildings. The fact that they are strong and do not lose their purity and beauty for many years is proved by the example of Usmania University Arts College building. They are also being used as a polished stone for flooring of the building. In these days, sand deposits getting diminished year by year. These stones are powdered to be mixed in the cement instead of sand for being used as a considerable scale in construction. The Buddha, who now stands against the Hussain Sagar, was also sculptured from the granite. Besides the black gold coal, these granite deposits are great gifts of nature to Telangana. Race and social structure. People of this region belonging to the Dravidian race. They are of a black and brown complexion. Though the mother tongue of the people here is Telugu, due to the 433 years of long rule of Qutub Shahis and Nizams, not only the students of those days were made to learn Urdu, their Telugu accent had its effect. As a result, compared to the accent of the Rayalaseema and Andhra regions, it had regional variations and newness. Glimpse provinces of Shatavahana age. Shatavahanas ruled Telugu, Marathi, Kannada and some parts of Gujarat after the decline of the Mauryas. The sources described them as contemporaries of Mauryas. There was no uniform opinion among the historians. Scholars on certain issues, certain cases wrote that who are Shatavahanas, what is their original home, what is their caste, what is the real period of their rule, how many Shatavahana kings ruled over the Andhra Desh. Eminent historian V.S. Sukankar, Shatavahana kings ruled over Andhra Desh. Eminent historian V.S. Sukankar tried to prove that Ballari in Karnataka is the original home of Shatavahana. He tried to support his above view on the basis of information collected from the later Shatavahana king Pulamavi or Myakha Dhoni inscription in Karnul. Pulamavi or Myakha Dhoni inscription Karnul. And Hira the Gully copper plate grant of Pallava king Sivaskanda. See, basis of the information collected from the later Shatavahana king Pulamavi, Ballari was the original home of Shatavahana king. He tried to support this above view on the basis of the information collected from the later Shatavahana king Pulamavi's Myakha Dhoni inscription in Karnul and Hira the Gully copper plate grant of Pallava king Sivaskanda Varma. According to V.V. Mirasi, another great historian, Vidarbha is the birth of the place of the Shatavahanas. D.D. Sarkar, Gopal K. Gopalachari, P.T. Srinivas Iyengar and Bhandari tried to establish Maharashtra as the birthplace of Shatavahanas. According to the R.G. Bhandarkar, the original home of Shatavahanas is located between the Krishna and the Godavari rivers. They hail from the coastal Andhra. Dhanayakatakam is their capital. V.S. Smith and Burgess identified Srikakulam is their first capital city of the Shatavahanas. According to them, the authority of the Shatavahanas extended over the Krishna Godavari Delta region. H.C. Roy Chandari and Murthy Venkat Rao has identified coastal Andhra as the motherland of Shatavahanas. On the basis of the recent excavations carried out at the Kotelingala, Karimnagar, and informating collected from the coins, monuments, and inscriptions, scholars like P.V. Parabrahma Shastra and Dhima Raju Reddy and Thakur Raja Ram Singh, V.V. Krishna Shastri has concluded that Kotelingala is the first homeland of Shatavahanas. Further, the above scholars declared that from Kotelingala, the Shatavahana king expanded their authority over the coastal Andhra and Maharashtra. Their sources founded at Peddabankur, Dhulikatta, Kondapur, etc. are also supporting the view of the above scholars. In the recent times, the above view received support from the majority scholars who are Shatavahanas. Whether Shatavahanas and the Andhras are one and the same, etc. In the recent times, the above view received support of the majority scholars who are Shatavahanas. Whether the Shatavahanas and Andhras are one and the same issues were also debated by the learned scholars. Excavations carried out by the Department of Archaeology at Kotelingala, Peddabankur, Dhulikatta, Siddhipeta are also giving valuable historical information about the Shatavahanas. Gautamiputra Shatakarni, the greatest king among the Shatavahanas, issued silver coins. On the Shatavahana coins, the name of the ruler, his mother name, father's name, and the symbols of bull, elephant, lion. Moon, lotus, etc. are also placed. At Kotelingala, the coins of Shatavahana, Shimuka, Shatavahana, Shatakarni 1 are found. After a careful study of the coins of the Shatavahana and Shimuka found at the Kotelingala, B.N. Shastri and Dhima Raju Reddy declared Kotelingala as the first political center of birthplace. In the year 1970, a postal employee, Sangana Bhatla Narahari Sharma of Kotelingala, handed over the Shatavahana coin which he collected to the P.V. Parabrahma Shastri. After a careful study of these coins, also Shastri concluded that the original home of the Shatavahana is Kotelingala. In the recent excavations at Fanigiri, Nalgonda, the coins of the Rudrasena II are found. The coins with the boat and ship figure of the Yagnashri Shatakarni are found at the excavations at the Nagarjuna Konda. These gives an idea about the flourishing state of external trade between Roman Empire. Shatavahana kingdom. The details given in the Periplus of the Eritrean Sea are supporting the above details. That is, see the Nalgonda excavations, the coins of Rudrasena II are found. The coins with the boat and ship figure of Yagnashri Shatakarni are found at the excavations at Nagarjuna Konda. They give us an idea about the flourishing state of external trade between the Roman Empire and Shatavahana king. The details given in the Periplus of Eritrean Sea are supporting the above details, the large number of Roman gold coins found at the Nagarjunakonda, Amaravati, Dharanikota, Jagayapeta, etc. are also supporting the flourishing state of external trade between the Andhra Desha and Roman Empire in the 1st century. Excavations buildings. The Department of Archaeology in the past 50 years period has conducted excavations at Fanigiri, Gajulabanda, Kondapur, Kodilingala, Pedabankur, Kadambapur, Dulikatta of Telangana region and Amaravati, Battipurolu, Jagayapeta, Shalihundala and Gudivada, Guntupalli of Andhra region. In their excavations, they discovered many articles, tools, weapons, coins, remains of houses, forts, palaces, wells, granaries, terracotta figures, etc. After careful study of them, they prepared reports. These reports are containing useful information about Shatavahana histories and culture. Chaitya, Stupa are also found at these sites at Kondapur, Medak. There are more than 400 coins are found by the archaeologist, eminent historian Mallampally Somashekhar Sharma described Kondapur as a chief mint Thankashala of Shatavahana age. According to the Dhimaraja Reddy, the coins of Gautamiputra Shatakarni, Vashishta Putra Shatakarni and Shivashri Pulumavi III Yagnashri Shatakarni are there in the coins heap found at the Kondapur. A brief political history of Shatavahana rulers. Chimukha founded the Shatavahana dynasty rule in Telangana with Kotilingala as its headquarters. This view of modern scholars has received support of majority historians in the recent times. His successors expanded their authority over coastal Andhra, Maharashtra and Gujarat. Kotilingala, Paitana, Dharanikota, Dhyanakatakam, Amaravati stood as their headquarters. There was no uniform opinion among the scholars regarding the total total number of Shatavahana rulers and the total period of rule. According to the Puranas, the total number of Shatavahana rulers is 30 and they ruled for a period of more than 2 centuries. Evidence collected from the Shatavahana inscription, the total number of Shatavahana kings is often easy 15 and they rule lasted over Andhra Desha for a period of more than 100 years. According to the eminent numismatist D. Raja Reddy, Shatavahana Srimukha Chimukha is one and the same ruler. Shatavahana Srimukha Chimukha was one and the same ruler. Jaina sources are providing little information about the Chimukha and he ruled for the period of 20 years. Krishna Shatakarni 1, Shatakarni 2, Hala, Gautamiputra Shatakarni are the famous kings of the Shatavahana dynasty. Gautamiputra Shatakarni 78 CE to 102 CE. Gautamiputra Shatakarni was the greatest king not only of all the Shatavahanas but also of the entire early South Indian kings. So Gautamiputra Shatakarni 78 CE to 102 CE. Gautamiputra Shatakarni was the greatest king not only of all the Shatavahanas but also of the entire early South Indian kings. He was the 23rd ruler of the Shatavahana Empire. He ruled for a period of 24 years. He was named after his mother Gautami. His victories are known through the inscription Nashik inscription of Balashri. When he came to power, his kingdom was limited only to the places east of Prastishthapura, east of Pratishthapura of Andhra Desha. Fanigiri, Nalgonda Stupam, Nalgonda Stupam, Fanigiri, Nalgonda Stupam. He made many conquests and expanded his kingdom. He destroyed the Kakas, Yavanas, Falavas and Kshatriyas. In the 18th year of his reign, he invaded on Kshatrepas and killed his enemy, Nahapana. The Jogalthambi hoard containing the coins of Nahapana, restruck by the Gautamiputra Shatakarni, attest his victory over the Saka. As the king, that result, Mulaka, Asaka, Asika, Vidharva, Nupas, Aparanta, Kukura, Avanti, Ujjain, etc. passed into his control. Due to all these historic victories, the empire of the Gautamiputra Shatakarni extended from the Rajasthan in the North India to Vaijayanti in Karnataka and Kadalur in Tamil Nadu. The Nashik epigraph describes him as a Trisamudra Thoya Pita Vahana. Trisamudra Thoya Pita Vahana. Kshatriya Dharpa Mana. Kshatriya Dharpa Mana Mardana. Agama Nilaya. Eka Brahmana. So also the Nasik epigraph, Nasik inscription of the Balashri describes him as a Trisamudra Toyapita Vahana Kshatriya Darpamana Mardana Agama Nilaya Eka Brahmanam Vashishti Putra Pulamavi ascended the throne after the Gautamiputra Shatakarni. After him and his successor were weak Ikshvakus declared their independence in Telangana, coastal Andhra, Abhiras in Maharashtra, in Karnataka, Chutu Satakarnis also carved their independent kingdoms. Karnataka Chutu Satakarnis also carved their independent kingdoms. Glimpses of Shatavahana Age. The age of Shatavahana has achieved significant progress in political and cultural fields. Their services to the South Indian culture as well as were well appreciated by many scholars. Administration. The contemporary literary works of Shatavahana period, foreign travel, accounts and epigraphs are throwing some light on the nature and polity and administrative system of Shatavahana. Especially Nashik and Karle epigraphs are provided very useful information. Shatavahanas continued the Mauryan form of monarchy. They provided political, cultural and administrative unity in to South India. They protected South from the Saka invasions. According to the eminent historian Sardar Panikkar, Shatavahanas built vast empire between Aryavrata, Dravida Desha, between Aryavrata and Dravida Desha. Rendered great services to the enrichment of the culture. Their rule worked as a bridge between the North Indian and the South Indian culture. Political systems of South India, Shatavahanas, have become a model to their successors in the South. King occupied pivotal place in the Shatavahana administration. He enjoyed extensive powers. He was not only the head of the government, but he was a supreme authority in the judicial and military affairs. Hereditary form of monarchy was invague. Young princess or Yuvaraja was given training before his accession. The king was considered as a god on the earth. Amatya, Sarva Senatipati, assisted the king in administration. The vast empire was divided into a number of provinces known as Aharas. In epigraphs, the name of Govardhanahara was mentioned. Mahamantras were in charges of Aharas. Nagaras were also known as Nigama. Mahamantras were in charges of Aharas. Nagaras are also known as Nigama. The civil bodies are known as Nigama Sabhas. The Bhattiprolu epigraph mentioned about the Nigam Sabha. The king was assisted by Amatyas. The king was assisted by Amatyas, Mahamatras, Vishwamatras, Maharathas, Mahabhojakas, Mahasenadipati, Bandara, Hiranika, Dutaka, Lekaka, Nibandakara, Mahaftakaraka, Gramaka and other officials. Village administration. Village stood as the base of the administration. After Ahara, village was the next unit. Gramika or Gumika or Gaulmika was the head of the village. The Hiraha Dagalli epigraph and Gada Saptashati are referring about the Gumika. The Gamika sometimes also exercises power on more than one villages. Headship of the village was hereditary. Collection of land revenue and maintenance of the law and order in the village were the chief duties of the Gramika. The village officials enjoyed good hold in the political system. In Kama Sutra, references are there about the Vetti system in villages. Military organization. Contemporary native literary works and foreign travel accounts are giving information about the military organization of Shatavahanas. According to the Pliny, they maintained a huge and strong army. King was chief of the army. Mahasenadipati was in charge of the recruitment, training and payment related to the armed soldiers. King himself led the army on the eve of the war. Their army consisted of cavalry, elephants, infantry and chariots. The military camps was also known as Skanolavaram or Kalakam. Kalakam. Shatavahanas also built and maintained many types of forts at Kotilingala, Dhulikatta, Bastins, and Simhadwaras, and are found during the excavations. Knives, swords, dalu, shields are also found at the above sites. Judicial system. Shatavahana continued the judicial system of Mauryan rulers. King was the highest judge, but he always honored the law recommended by the ancient experts. Civil and criminal cases were dealt separately. At provincial village level, the officials of the king solved the criminal and civil cases. Economic conditions. Land revenue stood as the primary source of income to the state. The state officials collected two types of taxes known as Rajabhoga and Deyamaya. Deyamaya. 1/6 of the production was collected as a land revenue. According to the details mentioned in the Nasik inscription, Gautamiputra Shatakarni had collected land revenue as per the rules. Besides land revenue, the state officials also collected taxes on road, ports, professional groups, santas, mines. Periplus of Erythraean Sea describes the external trade between the Shatavahana and the Roman Empire. Gada Saptashati gives the list of villages, village professional groups. It also states that each professional group has formed into a Sreni. The epigraphs of Shatavahana are containing the list of 17 types of guilds. Among them, Dhammaka, Moolakara, Kulika, and Kilapisaka, Bhata Yatrika, and Blacksmith, Kammara, Potter, Kularika, Vadaki, Carpenter, Goldsmith, Suvarnakara, etc. are very active in the society. The head of the each guild or Shreni was known as Shreshti. Shreni became very powerful in the course of time. Paitan, Thagara, Karahata, Nashik, Govardhana, Vaijayanti, Dhyanakataka, Dhyanakatakam, Vijayapuri are major ports of Shatavahana age. On the western coast, Barukacha, Sopara, Kalyana. Eastern ports are Ghantashala, Mysolia, Kaddura. Roman coins were discovered. Religious conditions. Along with Vedic religion, Jainism and Buddhism had flourished in the Deccan during the age of Shatavahanas. Early Shatavahana rulers were the followers of Vedic religion and worked for the cause of its progress, but most of them were known for their religious tolerance. The Nashik epigraph refers about the different gods and goddesses. Rama, Keshava, Arjuna, Bhimasara, etc. The heroes of Ramayana and Mahabharata are mentioned in it. The Gada Saptashati King Hala in the beginning and the end of the work recited the glory of Pashupati and Gauri. The largest Shivalinga belonging to 2nd century AD was found at Gudimallam in Chittur district, that is CB. In Gada Saptashati, King Hala, in the beginning and the end of the work, recited the glory of Pashupati and Gauri. The largest Shivalinga belonging to the 2nd century AD was found in Gudimallam in Chittur district. Recent discoveries are providing interesting information about the popularity of Jainism and its Tirthankaras. And Sheetalanatha, the 10th Jain Tirthankara, hails from the Bhadrachalam in Khammam district of Andhra Desha, present Telangana. Sheetalanatha, his grandson propagated Jainism in Andhra Desha. Gautamiputra Shatakarni adorned the titles such as Agamanilaya and Eka Brahmana. Buddhism and its philosophy also received greater importance during this period. During the lifetime of Buddha itself, it spread to Telangana, Andhra regions. According to one version, even Buddha visited Amaravati on the request of Shabala King Narendra. According to the Kathavastu Sagaram, Buddhism entered into Telangana long before the commencement of the Emperor Ashoka rule. That is, Buddhism and its philosophy also received great importance during this period. During the life of the Buddha itself, it spread through Telangana, Andhra regions. According to one version, even Buddha visited Amaravati on the request of Shabala King Narendra. According to the Kathavastu Sagaram, Buddhism entered into Telangana long before the commencement of the Emperor Ashoka's rule. The Bavari story in Suttanipada. The Bavari story in Suttanipada is an example to this Bavari, who has lived at Kavitavana Island on Godavari River, located in Asmaka, Karimnagar, Nizamabad, Adilabad, sent 16 of his learned disciples to meet the Buddha, who was at Rajagriha. That is, the Bhavari story in Suttanipada is an example of this Bhavari, who has lived at Kavitavana Island on Godavari River, located in Asmaka, Karimnagar, Nizamabad, Adilabad, sent 16 of his learned disciples to meet Buddha, who was at Rajagriha. they met Buddha, heard his preaching and accepted Buddhism. When they returned, they informed their guru Bavari about this. He had also accepted Buddhism. According to some scholars, that Bavarkurti in Karimnagar district is his native place. Kathavastu Sagara refers to the participation of Andhakas, Andhras, in the third Buddhist council held at Pataliputra. That is, Kathavastu Sagara refers to the participation of Andhakas or Andhras in the third Buddhist council in Pataliputra. Shatavahana are also known for their policy of religious tolerance. They respected Jain, Buddhist and Hindu scholars, philosophers. The present Telangana, Andhra, Maratha areas were under their rule. Many stupas, chaityas, viharas were built by the Shatavahana kings, queens and their officials. Nasik, Kanheri, Bedsa, Amaravati, Nagarjunakonda, Bathipurulu, Shalihundala, Ghantashala, Jaggayapeta, Gundupalli, Gudivada, Goli, Andhra region, Kondapur, Fanigiri, Buddhist are famous centers in Telangana region. Mahayana sect of Buddhism received great support. Buddha became the popular god. Acharya Nagarjuna was a contemporary of Yajneshri Shatakarni. He was a versatile genius and scholar in many shastras. He was an expert in Buddhist philosophy. According to the Lankavatara Sutram, he was born in the village named Vedali, located in the present Telangana. He founded the University of Mahayana Center at Amaravati and Nagarjuna Konda. His important works are Prajnaparamita Shastra and Rasaratnakara, Arogya Manjari, Shulleka. And philosophers assume that Nagarjuna's Shunyavadam, nothingness, was the basis of her Shankaracharya's Mayavadam. During the Shatavahana age, along with literature, art, architecture and sculpture, also made great progress in Prakrit and Sanskrit languages, excellent works in Prakrit and Sanskrit were written by scholar kings. Prakrit received the designation of the court or official language. Hala was a great scholar in Prakrit language. His work, Gatha Saptashati, describes the rural life in 700 stories. This work was... Hala was a great scholar in Prakrit. His work, Gatha Saptashati, describes the rural life in 700 stories. This work was translated into many languages. Some of the Telugu terms such as Attam, Ammi, Addam, Putti, Paddi are mentioned in his work. Hala was also assisted by women scholars like Anu Lakshmi, Anupa Lapta, Reva, Madhavi, etc. Durvinita, the Ganga king, also belonging to this period. Gunadya's work, Brihat Katha, also gives glimpses of social life of the age. According to the Krishna Shastri, Kondapur is the native home of Gunadya. Sarvavarman was another famous contemporary scholar of Hala. His work, Kathantra Vyakarana in Sanskrit, Kshemendra's Brihat Katha Manjari also belonged to this age. Kutuhala wrote Leelavati. It describes the marriage of the king Hala with a Simhalian princess Leelavati. He married her in the presence of Bhimeshwara temple located on the bank of the river Godavari. During the Shatavahana age, Dhanyakatakam Nagarjunakonda became popular educational centers. Students from various parts of the India and Southeast Asia joined and studied here. During the Shatavahana age, many stupas, chaityas, cave temples, guhalyas are built. They are symbols of Buddha's liberal ideas. Amaravati stupa was the masterpiece of this age. Stupas are also found at Jaggayapeta, Bhavikonda, Sailihundala, Ghantashala, Fanigiri, Dhulikatta, etc. During their period, painting also made progress. The paintings of Ajanta cave, during the period, paintings were also made progress. The paintings of Ajanta cave number 9 and number 10 were classical examples of excellent contributions of their age. Thus, after Mauryas, Shatavahanas built a vast empire in South India. They worked for the cause of patronizing fine arts.